I'm running very slow today. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. It's not Thanksgiving, but I've been saying that to everybody who's coming by. I gotta take a piss. Oh shit. I almost pissed in my pants right now. Kinda did a little bit. Anyway, peace. Oh no, I'm in trouble. Man, you see me. It's on for a little. Forgive yourself. Somebody got to see this. Somebody needs this, you know? This guy's looks like it's a few steps away, huh? City where we're from. People making millions over there. And around the corner, there's a woman getting killed by the pimp that they're putting all their trust in, man. Someone's killing this guy for stealing a $10 sack. Someone's killing this guy for, I don't even use that language, but around the corner, there's some suit wearing dude with all this money. He makes women do things for him so he could put them higher in his business and shit like that. What I'm saying, in that little area with all those buildings, a lot of power plays going on. A lot of treachery. I'm sure there's some angels amidst all that. The crows trying to push the hawks away. I wonder if there's any crossbreeding going on between crows and hawks.
Kind of looks a little girly.
But be confident. Nothing wrong with it. And I kind of got caught slipping because there's some people in front of me. Don't usually like to do that in front of people. Feel a little embarrassed. That was my first sprint and like since the day they took my truck. It was 2 Thursdays ago. I don't know, I'm feeling pretty good right now. I just went for my run up the hill. Or semi around people. There's some nice ladies that walked up. A lot of people walking today. Some of them were off this week. A lot of people with their children, because like I said, they're off. Or ladies. And the reason why I bring that up about my mind state right now is I could see the training center where the cops go train. They might judge me. They might think I'm just a piece of shit criminal, but I'm gonna say, feel bad, you know, there's some good cops out there. I'm always saying, fuck the sheriffs, they took my truck, motherfuckers. Guess I'm just a little bitter about how they raided my house. I was only an 18, 19 year old kid doing art, I guess, somewhere right there. Lies a little bitterness towards them. The ignorant ones that get people of people that live a certain lifestyle and judge them, and, you know, always come at them with an aggressive nature. It's like I put them in the same category as bullies, like the gangbangers who are bullies and use their fucking social engineering, their evil ways to create groups to go against people who try to create change. But for the ones that's working their job and are good husbands and good fathers, may the world keep blessing.
And the beautiful lady officers as well.
Anyway, got my shoes back this morning. Thanks to my stepdad Jesse, took me to get the rest of my stuff from my truck. And I saw this video about just hanging from the bar at least 5 minutes a day. Works on your grip and the compression in your back, strengthens your shoulders, they said. Even helps heal injuries and makes injuries stronger. Sometimes we think we're injured, but we might just need to work on that muscle more. Let's try some monkey bars. Rest works, man. It's a little homie, my brother's friend. This is winter in Cali, man. This morning it's still summertime. It's beautiful, man. All right, I went for my run today. Didn't realize it'd be that echoey. But echoey. Didn't realize it would have that much echo. Oof. So my legs are very tired. I walked from my mother's house. What's up, big dog? To the school. But here's where they do work on clay stuff. Like pottery. It's pretty dope. But got my counseling meeting right now. I made it to level ground. And talk later, there's a bunch of people coming. I guess I'm a night student now. So, sweet. This is, you have successfully added the class. Sweet. Okay. See how it goes. Letters and ad code should be entered using all capitals. Okay. Bing. I hate ringing bells, I swear. What's up, boss? Pretty cool. It's like a pottery class. Cielo, gotta go to school. So much fun at school. You don't want to work a job you don't like. So when you go to school, there's many options and you can kind of figure out what you like. That's why you keep going to school. So it's like, all right, well, you know, you may not know what you like to do yet. So kind of a little dusty. I really love to exercise because, you know, being made fun of, this is like one of these things where you say it's ego, I don't know what you could say, but, you know, since, you know, being made fun of by your parents, it kills your confidence. So it kills you mentally and psychologically in a sense, but it makes you find it important, like, you know, oh, I gotta look good, you know, because that's all I got to offer. So I'm thinking, if I get this job right here at this warehouse,
you know, it's a during the day job. And then, because like right now I ended up just having to, I didn't have to, but I ended up picking courses that were going to be at night. And so, I don't know. Part of me still believes I could challenge myself and be like a, and pick this pretty, I don't want to say extravagant, because that kind of is also in the appearance sense, extraordinary career path, you know? And, but like I said, people, it's more important to pay rent, you know? But let's say if I worked and went to school so I could pay rent, I wouldn't be able to get my physical, you know, desires fulfilled in a sense. I wouldn't have time to go run. I guess I could run, but not every day like I like, you know? It's just running, you know? I guess that's what I'd like to do. I like to run. And, you know, that's only like an hour a day. I guess I could find a way to fit that in, but the courses I'm taking is gonna take a lot of effort and a lot of time to like study, you know? I don't know. I don't think I could ever see myself not being in shape. But I would have to sacrifice, I guess. But I did try to come to school. I mean, you see me trying, once you're gonna see that I did register. It's not like I had to pay for classes yet, because the classes don't start till next year, which is January 28th. So I got time. So chances are I may just give up this smell like shit right here. But I may just give up this dream of school. I mean, fuck it. Like I said, I think my desire to stay fit and in shape to me is more important than even going to school and getting this other career that I'm kind of interested in. I don't want to say what it is until I actually like try to go and do it, because if I do try to go and do it, I would be serious about it, you know? But like I said, it's not something that's easy. But I would love my daughter to try to do it. I want her to get confident that she could do it, you know? Like right now, I'm passing this young lady who's working at this flower shop right here. And she just seems like she's miserable. Like she's like dumping out the water. Like, well, believe in yourself. She's probably doing something. She's probably, that's a job. Maybe she's like, her mom's been working there and her mom just got her this little side job. But maybe if she showed some effort to do something else, her parents would probably, you know, would be like, you know what? This kid is fucked. This is our kid right here. She's super, you know, she wants to do this, you know? Whether it's medicine, whether it's psychology, being a doctor, you know, or sociologist, or science, even science, you know, science is a beautiful thing. But you don't realize that till like, you're like, fuck, I'm homeless, or fuck, I have to work this shitty job. And it's not like, maybe this is her part-time job, and she still thinks like, oh, well, I'm gonna just be, you know, I am going to school, but I'm only just gonna be this social worker. Like, shout out to my sister, she's a social worker, but, you know, if you believed in yourself, you could do a little more. You know, you could be a psychologist. You could be a psychiatrist. You could be a therapist. You could, even beyond that, like I said, you could be a surgeon, you know? So, I don't know. Like I said, working out for me helps me, because my mind, you know, it'll, like right now when I was with this counselor, I'm like at this point where my mind was like where I wish it was when I woke up, you know, because I was so tired. I've been walking a lot, and I did go running today. I ran like a couple miles, and I ran a couple miles up the hill, and then I walked all the way home. Then I ended up walking back to make this, you know, appointment to register for some classes. And, you know, when I was in front of this gentleman, you know, even though he was an older man, he was educated, he's a counselor, I felt like I was like noticing things with him and his coworkers that I'm like, okay, I'm like, you know, I was just too tired to even, like, you know, nothing. I wasn't even anxious, nothing. I was like in a perfect position because of me working out, you know, and I don't know. Yeah, I don't know, just my thoughts. Aloe, you know, because, you know, I was going to visit my friend a lot, my friend Gary at the hospital, and that's beautiful. Like, the beautiful nurses, you know, be an RN, you know. You could be in register nurse. You could be the highest of nurses. You could be, you know, an anesthesiologist is pretty much the nurse of a surgeon. You know, it's you know, when my biological father had a heart attack, like, I don't know, was it like close to like 7-8 years ago, maybe even less. I don't know. It was about five years ago. I remember we were nervous as a family, like, he's about to go into war. Like, they're like, we're, you know, he's gonna be fine. You know, the anesthesiologist and the doctor were right there, like, he's gonna be fine. You know, those are the two that talk to the family before he goes into surgery. It's the anesthesiologist and it's the doctor, the surgeon. And, you know, you could do that, Elo. You should do that, you know? You know, like, even me, like, throughout my life, even throughout all this instability, I was like, man, I wish I could, I want to volunteer at a hospital. You know, and even when I was visiting Gary, the last time I seen him, there was this young lady, and the volunteers wore purple, and she seemed like she might have been a college graduate. She's like, I'm just a junior in high school. But she was asking, like, oh, she just goes around and asks the patients, oh, do you want water? Like, do you need something? She's not cleaning them up or nothing. She's just making sure if they need water or just if they need something, really. She wasn't doing much, but she's there seeing what the hospital entails, you know? So, Aloe, if you settle your mind down and you believe in yourself and you don't have that FOMO, that fear of missing out, because what happens is you're afraid of missing out in the moment, and then you realize you're 30 years old and you're missing out, really missing out on what the world has to offer. You know, at that point, you could have, like me, right, 32, if I would have been graduated already, had the career that really, you know, well, parents have to show their kid that, who they are, really, like, you know, what do you like, Ella? What do you like? What do you like, you know? Oh, because you were bullied. Oh, because, you know, so you have compassion and empathy for people. You want to help people, you know, son, even a man, you know, you could have been a nurse. Oh, you could have been a doctor to help people, you know? And doctors aren't just, like, doctors of medicine. There's doctors of the mind, the PhDs in psychiatry, psychology, sociology. Even scientists are doctors, you know, they have their PhD in science and they're doctors, you know, and that's their title. So education is beautiful. Medicine is beautiful. The brain is beautiful. The heart is beautiful. And I guess what I'm trying to show my daughter right now is, you know, your dad's, you know, trying. Even your mom tried to go to school for a little bit, you know, like it's not about tattoos. It's not about fucking drugs and the ego. It's not none of that, you know. It is about exercising and balancing your body with your mind, you know. Peace.
It has always been enough to be part of the natural sequence of things. Sure as the tides, nature and my guide. The marsh knows all about death. And doesn't necessarily define it as tragedy. Certainly not a sin. It understands that every creature does what it must to survive. And that sometimes, for prey to live, its predator must die. I am the marsh now. I am the feathers of an egret. I am every shell washed upon the shore. I am a firefly. You'll see hundreds beckoning far into the dark reaches of the marsh. And that's where you will always find me. Way out yonder, where the crawdads sing.